Welcome back, students. We were discussing the topic regarding the diversity in the living organisms. So now let's see the classification of vertebrates. The first class of vertebrates are the amphibians. Amphibians mostly have moist skin. They have lay jelly coated eggs in water, and they live in land as well as water. So the first class of animals is amphibians, which have mostly have the skin. Again, they lay eggs which are jelly coated in water, and they live in land as well as in water also. The example for this can be the specific lizards and all, as well as frogs. Next comes the class of birds. Birds have feather and they have hollow bones. They lay hard shelled eggs, and they are mainly considered as warm-blooded animals. So second class of animals is birds. Then comes the fish. Fish have wet scales. The skin of the fish mainly have scales on their body. They lay eggs in water. They mainly live in the water. So they are also called as aquatic animals. Next comes the mammals. Mammals have hair and produce milk. The main thing that they are called as mammals is that they can also give birth to young ones. That means they do not lay eggs, and they are also considered as warm-blooded animals. Next comes the reptiles. Reptiles have dry scales. As you can see here, they have dry scales. They lay eggs which are leathery shielded, and they are considered as cold-blooded animals. So students, in this session we have seen some of the classes of vertebrates. Like first is the amphibians, which live in both land and water. They lay jelly coated eggs in water. Next comes the birds. They lay hard shelled eggs, and they are considered as warm blooded animals, and they are also called as avians, as they can fly and breathe. Next comes the fish. Fish is called as aquatic animal, as it lives in water. It lay eggs in water and has wet scales. You can see wet skin mainly. Next class is the mammals. Mammals give young born to the live offspring. They do not lay eggs. They are also considered as warm-blooded animals, as well as they have hair and they can produce milk. Next comes the reptiles. Reptiles have dry scales. They can lay eggs which have leathery shell, and they are considered as cold-blooded animals. So students, in this session we have seen the classification. For the session, thank you.